Welcome to the final episode of Police Quest 3. This is episode 11, I think. I'm not sure. So, last week when I left you, we were standing over here. I got us all the way downstairs. And before we do anything else, I want to look at a picture because this is pretty important. So, the next part of our adventure relies on us knowing where things are. And the only way to do that is to look at this picture. So, we got your shadow again as you look at the photograph of JC and Michael Baines. I'm Lostwolfe, by the by. But over here, notice very clearly you can see 522 Palm. And this is important because this is kind of the last known whereabouts of these two men. Well, Michael Baines, anyway. So, what we're going to do, and I'm going to fade to black here and then meet you there. We're going to go to 522 West Palms and we're going to see what there is to see. Just a warning about this episode, there's a lot of dumb back and forthing now that they don't automate. I don't understand why, but they don't. Anyway, so what's going to be happening is we're going to be traveling between two sets of locations a lot. I'm not even going to announce it except for the first time. So that's what this episode is all about. Let's hop into the car. I will meet you at 522 West Palms. And we are here. This is what looks like the remainder of Michael Baines' house. I'll wait for you here, Sonny. And so you look at it. The front door is made of steel. It would look more at home in a military installation than in this rundown shack. The windows have been partially boarded over. Underneath the boards, you can see thick metal bars. The house looks like a shack, but judging by the barred windows and heavy front door, it's well fortified. So, naturally, we go knock. Because that's what you do. You can hear movement inside the house, but no one answers. So, okay, here's how this is going to play out. Because Sonny Barnes is a police officer and is part of the law, he now needs to go and get a warrant to get inside the house. So we're going to go do that. I'm going to meet you at the Linton Court, and we're going to go there and sort that out. I'll be waiting for you in the car, boss. So here we are at the courthouse. We're going to be doing a lot of this. This is going to go back and forth a bunch. Anyway, so the thing is that we need a warrant to search the house. So that's what we're doing here. You request to see Judge Simpson in her chambers. This is the funniest thing that's about to happen. Well, officer, what's on your mind? Well, stuff and things. Okay, so what you need to do here is you need to start off by giving her the paper, because that makes the most sense. You hand a news clipping to the judge. You try to convince the judge, but she insists on more evidence. This is the funniest thing. I can see you've done some good detective work, Officer Barnes, but I need more evidence to justify a search warrant. Oh, God. This is not real life, by the by, just so you know. This is not how this would happen at all. So you give her the picture. You told the judge how the photograph of Michael and Jesse Baines helped you locate the suspected crack house. Your Honor, I'm convinced that some sort of cult operating a crack house at this location. That's not even good English. There is some sort of cult. Well, this looks like a very nasty business indeed. You've sold me! I'll sign the warrant. I can't. Oh dear. Judge Simpson lays the warrant on the desk and says, good luck, officer. Contact me if you need any further assistance. Okay, so grab the warrant. And in typical Police Quest fashion, it just says, a search warrant. Anyway, let's run along. Now I'm going to meet you back at the suspected crack house, because we need to go back there again, so I'll meet you there. So, okay, we have a search warrant. And what we want to do is obviously want to get inside the house. I got the back setting. Keep your head down. So off Morales goes, and she's going to keep you covered from the back. But now the problem is that even though you have a search warrant, obviously there is somebody home. You'll have to find some other way to serve that search warrant. But you can't go barging in, and there's no way for you to slip the note in or anything. This is not my friend Inherit the Earth. So we're going to go back to the judge. Surprise. I'll be waiting for you in the car, boss. And here we are again. Surprise. Okay, so when this fails, because this is escalation at its finest, it totally is. So you can't serve the warrant for searching the house. You request to see Judge Simpson in her chambers. So your next bet is to do the following. Escalation at its finest. Oh, God. Okay. Judge Simpson looks up as you come into her chambers. I see you back. Did you have a problem with the warrant? No, not the warrant. Just gaining entry. The place is fortified. There's only one way to get into the house. I'm requesting a special order to use the department's ramming unit. Ram unit. She studies you closely, then says, I see. All right, officer. I trust your judgment. And just like that, she gives you a just make sure you have plenty of backup. And she even says, you know, don't worry, it's public property, but let's go blow it up. Because it's a suspected crack house. This is a judicial order, and again, in typical police quest fashion, a judicial order. It makes me so sad that they skimped out on those text boxes and didn't tell you a thing. Anyway, not surprisingly, we have to go back to the crack house, so I will meet you there. Okay, so here we are, and thanks to Judge Simpson, the RAM is in place and ready to go. And this is the only time in this episode that I'm going to have to save because it gets a bit crazy. I got the back, Sunny. Keep your head down again, and she runs off to the back. Now, you don't want to stand in the way of the RAM, so you've got to be on the left-hand side. Otherwise, you will die. And we need to save. This is episode 11. Whoa, I can't spell crack. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is draw the gun. And we need to sight it on ourselves. This signals readiness. Wait until I'm in position, then take out the door. And he's in position, the door goes down. From left. Freeze! Don't shoot! I'll give up! I'll give up. And just like that, he just gives himself in. It's a bit weird. Anyway, so we can't waste too much time here because if we do, I assume bad things happen. I'd never actually waste a time here. You feel a sense of satisfaction as you slip the cuffs on the wrists of Michael Baines. And then a generic police dude walks in. I'll take it from here, Sonny. And he takes Michael Baines off your hands. But things are not over. Because look at this. This is only the front of the house. Now you can't go to where he went or where he came from. But you can go here and you can find the snazzy remote control. Hooray! You look underneath the faulty cushion and find a remote control. Now, I don't know how you would know this, P.S., but what you're supposed to do is take the remote control, aim it at the TV, and hit 8. I don't know how you were supposed to ever know this. Anyway, that opens up this over here, and we can go inside. But again, we're going to save, because we might die here. Oops. There we go. So once again, we're going to draw our gun, because this looks awfully suspicious. And we're going to sight it on ourselves. And we're just going to, you know, have a quick look around. Doesn't seem like there's anything here. Oh well, time to go. Now I'm going to save again, because I might die. You shot him. Hold on while I check his vital signs, says Morales. And you wait patiently for her to do that. I'd like to say it was fun, Buns, but you've been a real pain in my ass, you male pig. Okay. I'm Detective Brooks, Internal Affairs. We've been keeping an eye on her since your report. Lucky I was here. Congratulations, you've not only solved your murder case, but you've also found an incapacitated, dangerous cult that was processing crack, not to mention dealing with your partner. Now all that's left is to fight the paperwork. You almost welcome the routine of it all. There is such a thing as too much excitement. So you, still on the clock, do something also hilarious. Oh, goodness. Please, quiet. You go to see your wife. But for now, let the cleanup crew do their job and the guilty sleep their dream of sleep. For you, there's suddenly nothing more important than seeing Marie. I don't think I'll ever be able to look at you again without feeling what I feel right now, without remembering what a miracle it is just to hold you. Speaking of miracles, Dr. Power has just given me a bit of news. Oh, Sonny. We're going to have a baby! A baby? I hope he has my low-pitched voice as well. LPD recently received this top-secret list of names and occupation of members of an electronic terrorist group. The gang leader, one Jim Pretty Boy Walls, has been known to threaten to shake London's future like so much putty. If it is not known at this time if the gang's intentions are for good or evil, or if they should even be taken seriously, nevertheless, be on the lookout for the following gang members. They are wanted for questioning. And then they do the programmers and all that stuff. This is the first game we're saying goodbye to, and that makes me sort of sad, but on the other hand, it's a police quest, and that makes me sort of happy. No more driving around. I played these games with my sister, and these games are all for her. I've been playing them all for her. I've had a blast playing them. Jane Jensen wrote this. That's so terrifying. There's also one other funny thing that I want to point out in this whole list, but... So I've had fun playing them and seeing them again 20 years long, because the last time I played them was when they came out. And it's been interesting revisiting them and seeing how we thought about police people back then versus how we think about them now. Where is it? No, it's not on this list. Josh Mandel was Lee in the Coroner. Hilarious. And it's been kind of fun, you know, going through these games. And I appreciate you guys coming with me for the ride. It's always fun to share these games with you. Next week, we'll be playing something different. Oh, there we go. Ames, the psychologist, is Corey Cole, who did Quest for Glory. So I'm glad that you guys come with me for the ride. I'm grateful to you for letting me into your houses to play these, specifically the Serial games. I love them a lot. And I wouldn't be... sort of doing this, well, I kind of maybe would ship these off to my sister, But I wouldn't be doing this, you know, if it wasn't for YouTube specifically. So thank you to YouTube, I guess Google, and thanks to you guys for all the support and all that sort of stuff that you give me. A representative of the SPCA was present at all times during the coding of the animal sequences. No animals were in actual danger. In any actual danger. Thank you for playing Police Quest 3. We hope it's been as entertaining as you have. It's been very entertaining. And it's going to loop like this now. So I'm going to say goodbye to you. We're going to see a new game next week. I have the plans. I know exactly what we're going to play. Serial games is not a problem because they're on a big list. So next week, we're going to be playing something I love to bits. And I'm looking forward to that. So thank you so much, everyone. I'll see you next week. Have a great week. And goodbye.